Hi guys and girls, and welcome to another episode of Monday Minutes. By the end of next week, someone will win an Oscar. That's why I'm wearing glasses, because it's Oscar time. But one of the most important categories are best film and best director. But what does a director do? How can you become a director? The director is someone who directs the film, or, you know, oversees the making of it. He or she needs to have a vision. He or she needs to communicate this vision to the whole team. It helps if you, you know, do every job on the film set. For example, you should try writing a movie. It's easier to direct if you've written your own movie. You should also star in one. Do every job you can think of. So it makes it easier for you to communicate your vision to your team if you know what everyone needs to do. You need to be able to visualize the script, some convey your story, what you want to tell. Some people, like Hitchcock or Michael Haneke, are very focused and really have a detailed script and everything planned. Others are really into improvisation. And some people combine those two techniques. You need to be able to keep deadlines and to stay focused, even if it's stressful and a lot of work. You need to be open to suggestions. If people think something is wrong, listen to them. Some people even act as their own composers, for example, Tom Tykwer or Clint Eastwood. Other people do the sound design, like David Lynch. So this sounds all very cool and nice, but how do you become a director? So you don't end up like me, freezing off your hands here in the cold. How do you become a director? So many people just write movies and then direct them, so break it down into visuals. Some people start as actors like Orson Welles, or others just start as a producer. Nonetheless, there are two key factors which tend to help you make it or break it: perseverance and luck. You need to be able to have a lot of money, or a bit of money, to feed your crew and to turn your script or someone else's script into a movie. And you need to keep making movies, because after you've done your first short film, you do the next one, and the next one, and the next one. And after you have 3 short films or 2 short films, you can apply for film school. By the way, quick question, what do the following directors have in common? Christopher Nolan, Woody Allen, Alfred Hitchcock, and Kubrick. They all never went to film school. You can go to film school, but you can, like me, start your own movie. The cinematographer of Citizen Kane told Orson Welles, who was new as a director, "I can tell you the basics in 2 weeks or 1 week, and then it's all about practice. So learn the stuff, buy good books." I put 2 or 3 good links in the description below. And, you know, make the next movie, write one, act in one, and help people out if they make their movies and make a lot of connections, and then you'll become a great director. Maybe I will do a second part on directing later on. So anyway, please let me know if you like this episode. Let me know in the comments who will win an Oscar and why, and who should have been nominated. What do you think of Lady Bird, by the way, or The Shape of Water? So that's been it for today, folks. Thank you very much. Stay curious and keep on learning. See you guys next week. Happy Oscars.